watching Buzz TV here today. Right here fishing the Clackamas River. I've been here since like 6:30. Around that time came in and it was already dark, and I'm down here fishing, side drift fishing here. I got a pencil lead, swivel, a little bead, down to like 5 feet a leader to Corky bead in a spawn sack. Here in Oregon and in the West Coast, I don't really use these that much, but the East Coast, they use them. These are pretty good. I normally like to fish way up there, but I went up there and it's just no bank, it's bad water, and it's not really good up there. So now I'm gonna just fish down here and hopefully for a coho or anything, honestly, but aiming for coho right now. So I wish you guys luck, and let's get started. So when you're side drifting with your weight, it could be cannonball, pencil lead, anything you want. In this case, I just got pencil lead. You want to cast upstream. You want your line to flow naturally. You want to feel it, you know. And when it comes down here, what you want to do in your set is you want to follow your line. And you see right here, my rod tip is going like this. That means you're bouncing on the bottom. If it does not, that means it's under your drifter. You don't have enough weight. And a lot of times people say, oh, it's bouncing like this, and it might get a little like snagged a little bit, and it might go like that. A lot of times it's not a fish. It could be just a snag. So you got to really double check, you know. Like when you're fishing like that. And side drift is one of my favorite ways. Side drifting, spinners, and plunking. My three favorite ways to catch salmon. There's nothing like that. Old school always works the best. You see my line is going like that. That's because that means it's bouncing on the rocks. You know? So I feel like white right here. Can you help land the fish, sir? Is it a hatchery? Oh my.